Isaiah chapter 38, verses 1 to 6 and 17 to 20, posed a question to us. As this Hezekiah, a king in Israel, for the reasons best known to God, sent a man of God to tell him, a whole God, the owner of heavens and earth, who speaketh and it cometh to pass. A whole God decided and said, my servant, the prophet Isaiah, go to the other servant, King Hezekiah. Tell him, he will surely die and not live again, because I love you. Set your house in order, because you will die now. That's God. He was not a boaster. He was not threatening. He met it. Surely, he has made up his mind. He has decided the matter of King Hezekiah. He has closed it. He has sent the word to him. I want you to see God how he is now. I want you to look at God how he is. I want to read it. He said, in those days was Hezekiah sick unto death, and Isaiah the prophet, the son of Amos, came unto him and said unto him, thus saith the Lord, set thy house in order, for thou shalt die in this sickness. You are going to die and not live. Hezekiah turned his face towards the wall and prayed unto the Lord. Listen now. And said, remember now, O Lord, I beseech thee, how I have walked before thee in truth and with a perfect heart, and have done that which is good in thy sight. And Hezekiah wept sore. The question. Now, can you pray the prayers of King Hezekiah in time of your trouble. Brothers, sisters, wherever you may be, in Nigeria, in Edo State, in Africa, in any part of the world, as you listen now, will you be so bold to present a case before the Creator of heavens and the earth, who said, now is your time to die? God is speaking. He does not say a word which he is not able to accomplish. And a human being, King Hezekiah, opened his mouth and said, God, I know you are a recorder. I know you know everything. Omnipotence, omnipresence, omniscience. There is nothing about my life, oh Lord, that you don't know. Remember now, before you say I must die, remember, oh God, how I have walked before you in truth. Remember, oh God, how I have done all things to please you. Oh, remember, oh God, how I have walked uprightly before you. He paused. And God looked up and down. And God remembered how he walked, how he spent his days, how he spent his nights. When you read the account of King Isaiah, you will see how he turned the wicked people of his domain to God. How he destroyed idolatry out of the land. The question, viewers, anywhere you may be, can you pray this prayer of King Hezekiah when you are in trouble? Search your heart. Whether you be a king or pastor or prophet or president or governor of any nation, can you stand in the house of God like Hezekiah and spread your hands and say, oh God, remember now how I have been serving you in truth and uprightness. Remember, oh God, how I have walked before you blamelessly. Can you be bold, you smoker, fornicator, idol worshiper? You are in the church. You are pretending. Adulterer. Secret court member. Putting on collar. Putting on rings from India. Using all manners of spiritism to preach the word. You that is polluted in your heart. If this type of problem come upon you, will you be bold to say, God, remember how I have walked before you in truth and uprightness? Can you challenge God with your present state of life? Can you challenge God if you are attacked by an enemy? Can you plead your own case before God and say, I have walked before you uprightly, God? For which of these good things do you want me to die? This is something that you must take in this year 2011. Straighten your record before God. Make your case clear before God. He listened, a whole God listening to someone who pleaded not guilty. God stood still and said, my servant Isaiah, something has happened. I cannot take that man now. Let him live and not die. Isaiah must have been surprised. And he changed the situation. He healed the man that was sick. There was no witness. There was no lawyer. It was him and God. In this year, I want you to understand, a time shall come when it will be you and God in your closet alone. And you want to talk to God for a particular reason. Can you pray the prayer of King Hezekiah? Can you claim innocency before God? A human being like you, telling God, who knows all things, that he is upright. And God agreed with him. God did not say, I will not listen. What would have been saying today among the preachers throughout the whole world, that how can a man claim to be righteous before God? How can a man claim to be holy before God? My friend, if you know whom you are, you can be bold before God, because he's your father. He loves you. He knows you. But because of our iniquities, we are not able to stand before God. Look at Adam. Look at Eve. God wanted to have fellowship with them. He called for them. He couldn't find them because of the state of disobedience. We have access to God now. We can do all things. Look at a human being like Apostle Paul. Said, I have finished my course. I have succeeded. He's talking to God. He said, now I know a crown of glory is laid down for me. He said, not for me alone, but for as many of you who will serve God faithfully. As for me, I have finished. I know where I'm going now. Can you be bold in the day of your trouble and present your case before God and say, God, I am your servant. I am your son. I am blameless. Yet, Hezekiah, a human being, saw a former spoiler, destroyer, turn to become Paul, an apostle. He's telling God he has finished his case. He has finished everything that God asked him to come and do. He said, henceforth, a crown of glory is laid down for me. What are you pursuing? Pastors? There are reports from all parts of Africa concerning pastors. Nigerian pastors, there are reports about you from all parts of Africa and beyond. Can you now tell God to hear your prayers for such a good work you have done? Look at, he added another